Okay. Hey, everybody. It is April 25th, Business Bucks Day. So I hope you all have your Business Bucks in for this month. And we are going to do a quick call. This is Uplift.org, and we are going to do a quick call on some of the changes that WildTree just announced. So you're going to see me, I forgot to take my glasses off. There's a weird glare in my office. The light is directly above, and some wonder what I'm doing. I'm going to be looking at my screen. So I've got Zoom on my phone that's filming me, but I'm going to use my screen to kind of go over the changes. So if you're wondering where my eyes are, if you can see me, I'm focused. I'm not ADD. I am ADD, but I'm looking at the email so I can get everything covered. Thank you for smiling, Tip and Jess, because I can see you guys. I hope the rest of you are laughing as well. Okay, let me get here. So last week they announced a couple changes that are pretty big and then a couple of minor changes. The big changes, some don't feel as positive, some feel really exciting. So let's start with a really exciting change, the app that's coming out. Ooh. Right? Yeah, the app is awesome. I can tell you this, it's going to work with any kind of phone. So I've been getting asked, can it work with, hey Tabitha, thanks for joining us. Can it work with Android? Can it work with iPhone? Yes, it's not going to matter. The app is going to be very functional for all kinds of phones, whatever your cell phone provider is, whatever. But I will tell you something. I can't tell you any more details than that. We're just not supposed to talk about things that we don't know about yet. I'm not going to overpromise and then underperform. I'm going to underpromise and perform. Okay? So I just can tell you, you can tell your customers. Sarah, I saw you had it on social media. I put it out there last week, I think, or the weekend. Who knows? But you can tell your customers about it. We just don't want to overpromise what it's going to do. There's going to be recipes and menu planning and all kinds of cool stuff. And that kind of rolls into the next big change that we have. So I'm going to talk about that. If you are coming to conference, you're going to hear all about the app. It's going to be a huge focus of training and point of reference at conference. If you're not sure about conference, I would love for you to reach out to me. I know it's an investment. I will do everything I can to break it down for you, help you pay for it. We'll figure it out together. But you have to reach out to me and you have to walk through it with me as far as, you know, what is the constraints? Is your spouse not supportive? Is it childcare? You know, what is it? But I can't tell you enough. I didn't go to the first conference when I joined. I joined at this time of the year. You guys know that, spring of 14. And I didn't go to conference till the very next year. And I just wonder what would have happened if I did, because Jess Schultz on our team went to that same conference with me. She went to my first conference, and it was her first conference. And she promoted to team leader the next month. We used to do 1 month to team leader. And she promoted and obviously has been a leader since. So I just share that because conference is so much more than just announcements and freebies and new products, which you get all of that, people. You get more in free products than you spend to go. So it's incredible. Like, I can't say it enough. Get your high need to conference. We'll help you. Okay, there's my spiel. So rolling into the app, one of the other big changes we've been told is that back in the day, we were able to sign up, you guys know this, with no minimums, right, in the whole year, as long as you did just $350 a year. And honestly, you guys, they gave you 18 months. If you never knew that, they never deactivated you. You just stayed active. But now we changed it to every 4 months as of this year. Everybody knows that, right? So April 30th is kind of a big day because those of us that have historically been with WildTree for more than, 6 months, we're coming up to be expired. So it's kind of fun in the back office to see the numbers. And of course, I'm reaching out to everybody this week, reminding them. So along with that now, you've always had the option of having a website or not having a website, and this is going to be the big change. Tiff, you messaged me today, and I want to cover this right away. You're now going to be paying for an e-suite. It's going to include the app. It's going to provide all the back office services, and unfortunately for some, not so much for those of us that are already paying for a website, it's going to be required, okay? I know it's going to mean that they're also pouring more resources into our back office to fix things that don't work well. So for those of you that know that it's clunky, I got that today from a rep on our team. She's really sweet, brand new, entering her launch party orders, and she used the word clunky. I thought, that's exactly perfect. Our back office is clunky. It's all in the works, okay? I think you guys hopefully got that feel from the email that we know there are some issues, the growing pains, can we call it that? WildTree's been small for 20 years. Family-owned business, and we need to take it to the next level. So I want you to think of the e-suite as a perk and as an advantage. If you're in the Idea Factory, you might have saw Tegan Braun's video today and her little fox leggings that she made. She covered it perfectly. You know, you're either going to be in or out, kind of. You know, you're going to have that mentality. Now, you can make it in between. You can stay a lifestyle rep here. Tiff had a great friend ask her about being a lifestyle rep. You can do that. If you want to just spend the approximate $100 a month, because let's be real, you got to spend about $80 in product. You guys understand that, right? And then you're going to have to pay the $15 or $14.95 for the e-suite. If that's okay with you and you want to be a part of WildTree, maybe sell to your family and friends, you can still sell that to people, you guys. You guys can sell the Business Builder Kit that way. And you can still stay here like that if that's you. But just know that it's going to be required from now on. Does that make sense? And does anybody have a question? A relevant question, not a thought at this point. You can give me thoughts as soon as we're done. Just a relevant question. E-suite. Yep.
I do. Does the $14.95 come off our commission or do we have to pay that separately?
It's been, okay, so this is confusing because it's changed 5 times in my 3 years, but Jess, I want you to back me up. Right now we pay it,
yeah.
Correct? We yeah. used to be able to take it off commissions and I'm understanding we'll still have to pay it. We used to have it off of commissions and people wouldn't make the money and then it wasn't getting paid. Does that make sense, what I'm saying? Okay. I don't have confirmation of that, Sarah, but I can find out for you, okay?
Yep, thank you.
Yep, I wish it came off pay too, because as builders, wouldn't that be nice to not have another thing? But in a way, well, it's just trackable.
It makes sense.
Right.
Not have to.
Yep, 100%. I get it. Okay, any other relevant questions about the eSuite? Quick, we kind of understand the concept, right, that the app is going to be coming with that. Again, Tegan pointed out the beautiful newsletter that goes out every month to your customers. If you're keeping your contacts clean in the back office, lots of positive things there. So, was I excited about $2 more? No, I'll tell you the truth. I was like, dang it, for someone that's doing over $1,000 a month, why can't they just give us the eSuite? You know, that thought crossed my mind because I'm a builder, right? But then I was like, okay, I guess this is another great way to ensure that we're building and we're not selling it as the better way to buy the Best of WildTree 8-Pack, that we're selling it as a business kit. And I thought Tegan's words were great. You guys made a choice when you bought the Business Builder Kit. I think somebody wants to make a guest appearance. Hold on. Say hi. Say, I'm supposed to be in bed, but I'll just sit with Mama for a second. Okay. So rolling into the next major change, let's talk about some pricing. So this is my least favorite change of all. Please don't push the buttons because they will all go bye-bye. The pricing change is hard. We can just say that, right? If you just hear pricing change a little bit, it doesn't seem like a big deal. But if you look through the prices and you know the WildTree pricing structure well, some items went up by a significant amount, like $2 to $3 an item, which will make something like oatmeal, sugar, and spice stirring not really appear. So what I'm going to say for right now is I want you all to look through that sheet. If you need a copy of it, I'll email it to you before I leave for Jamaica. And I just want you to kind of familiarize yourself so that it doesn't catch you off guard when the first couple customers ask you about the increase. Okay. And then I want you to realize that we had to do an increase because we really haven't had a major increase in years. Jess has been here nearly as long as me. And last year we had an increase on some oils and some products. But overall, that increase was minor compared to this. And one of my dear friends in WildTree who's been here much longer than me, more than double the time as me, today she said, honestly, I wondered when it was going to hit and if it was going to hit hard at some point. Leslie probably protected us from this because she, her heart would have wanted us to keep them as low as possible. 20 years ago, she carried a wood box of seasonings to her parties. And if she could do that still today, she would. So that just tells you, like, that's just her heart. And unfortunately, in the business world, we want to stay WildTree. We want to stay competitive and make money, right, and be able to pay the Snar Browns and all of you guys nice income and as you work to be Snar Browns. So that's just my opinion on that. It's hard to swallow. Familiarize yourself with it if you can and know that it absolutely had to happen. It's not something that you're not going to, like, see this again in 6 months. This isn't a red flag that we're going bankrupt or anything, but truly, honestly, some of the stuff do I feel like now it's going to be harder to sell? Yes. But do I feel like rancher steak rub and the oils probably needed to be looked at? Honestly, yeah, I figured. Blessings of this, they didn't touch the freezer meal workshop bundle. They brought back Easy Breezy crock pot to kind of, you know, subside that. And you guys, we are a solutions company anyway, so try to stay really branded and focused. I know, Tabitha, we talked about this today. When you love something, you'll sell it. Don't focus on the pancakes if the $12 price makes you mad. Because honestly, that's the one that ticked me off the most. How am I going to sell $12 pancakes to someone? Just to be really blunt, like, I'm not even going to talk about them unless someone asks me, okay? I'm no dummy in the market. I'm going to talk about the freezer meal workshop kit. Because now especially, they're very worth the money. Or how about the new menu planner for May? That's what I'm printing on my printer. I'm getting my May stuff ready to go. Oh, thank you, Macaulay. He brought me some folders just in case I want to do a party demo right now. So I'm going to focus on that, the solution. Think two, breakfast bundle, salad bundle. Make it what the customer wants, but think bundle versus individual price, and it doesn't seem as bad. Does that make sense? It won't seem as shocking to the customer. If you have specific price questions, I'm happy to go over them with you. Just like Mom's Meatloaf, not super impressed with that increase. Like, there's specifics I can tell you I think feel high now because they probably were so much lower. But otherwise, that's all I can tell you, is that it had to happen. And unfortunately, it's poopy that they did it in one big chunk. I think, Jess, you'd agree it was easier to swallow when it was like the oils and a few products last year. And then it felt like the rest of the catalog stayed the same. But I think they just did an overall market review. And again, there are Wild Tree leaders in on this that are getting a say, and there were other changes they wanted to make. And instead, they opted for these first. These were better to launch first to make a larger impact in the Wild Tree community. So any specific price questions? I mean, you can tell I'm least excited about this. It's hard to check my energy on this. When I go out the first time with the new catalog, I won't even want them to open the catalog if they're repeaters. I'll just want them to look at my pretty graphics that I bring in my folders, and that's it. But the reality, guys, if your energy is good, they're not even going to know. I promise you. I promise you that. People spend money in my business all the time without ever even needing to know the price. They just shoot me what they want, and they say, send me an invoice. So just make sure you share what you're excited about, and don't let the pricing drag you down. We can talk about it now to be educated and prepared, but don't go into your focus on the price. Oh, who's trying? I'm sorry. I keep interrupting you. Go ahead, whoever's on the phone.
I have a question. When is this price? Is this June 1st or what?
Yes.
When is the price increase?
Yeah, June 1st. And I think that's what I told. Isn't that what I said? I think so. I'll look really quick. I'll look.
It is.
June. And then for catalogs, are they changing the catalog?
Yep, that was in there. You do have to order new catalogs, and they're going to tell us mid-May when we can do it. So use what you have. And if you have a whole bunch, if anybody has a whole bunch, you might want to post in our team page, because somebody local might not have ordered enough for May, like me. And so there's a chance that people will buy that. You know, we could buy them off each other, save somebody a few bucks, help somebody else from having to pay the full shipping cost, and then we can all get our new ones when they announce it. So more reason to get your 350 in by the 10th of May. Place your order for catalogs as soon as they announce it. Savvy business owner, right? Okay, that's a good question, Lisa. Thanks. Who else has a question? Oh my goodness, you're heavy. Okay, so another one is the Hostess Min. Some of you might be having the hardest time with this one. For some, the pricing, again, you think of our products in bundles, or you talk about them in sets, and that doesn't seem like that big of a deal then. But the Hostess Min changing from $200 from a qualified party to $350 can feel like a pretty big jump. So that's what it is now, in case you didn't see it. You do get a half price item if you get up over $200, but you have to get to $350 to get the credits. The credits didn't change, though. The amount didn't change, but the credits where they start changed. Does that make sense to everybody? So instead of saying three workshop bundles sold to get your bundle at half price, I think it's five now. Has anybody done the math? I'd have to actually put it in the calculator. I can do that quick.
Yeah, right around four or five.
Yeah, you need to sell five. But then it's not half price. Does everybody understand what the difference is then? Then they're already at $350, so their credits are at like 50. Okay, I have to get Nate to take him. So chat amongst yourself for 1 second, because he's destroying the side of my, like, taking everything off the wall, which is not going to work for this OCD mom who's going to Jamaica. So chat for a second about this and help each other understand.
Macaulay, no. Okay, we're going to go by Daddy. I don't know why Daddy brought you in here.
Do we know when that starts? Does that start June 1st also? Does anybody know?
I believe June 1st for that as well.
Okay, what was the question? I missed it. Sorry.
Does that start June 1st also?
Yes, June 1st. Okay. And you're going to ask me the question, like, what happens if they were at 200 prior to June 1st and then they get another 100 after June 1st? And can you link it together? And because the party started in May, can you count? I don't know that. I'm guessing they're going to say after May 1st, it's got to be up over 350. So just plan accordingly. And one thing that you might be able to help offset in the beginning, if it makes you feel better as a human being, is that lots of us get outside orders throughout the month, right? And we take that and we claim that it's free credit, which is yours. But in the beginning, if it helps you, you, and I know Jess does this a lot of times to help her hostesses get up, we may have to offer that up, like, hey, I have a hostess that's really close. I do more of that. I guess more of that community feel, like, hey, I went out of stuff. I've got a hostess that's $32 away. Things like that. Because sometimes, in my mind, you guys, we're so used to 200 that so many of you walk out the door without realizing it, that you're just trying to get a minimum party. I never, hardly ever am going to struggle with this because I don't have hostesses that have this issue. But I don't go at my business looking for $200 parties. I'm not looking for $200 hostesses. I'm just not. I'm looking for $500 to $1,000 hostesses. And they know that. I feel like they can feel it, that I'm going to do everything I can if they do everything they can. Now, don't get me wrong. Some workshops have 3 bundles sold. And of course, that's going to mean, who knows what that's going to mean on the front end. She has 3 bundles sold. What does that mean?
She has to pay for her bundle.
Full price. That's going to be when it hits us. Because I never pretty much, and I'm sure many of you feel the same way, have a party that once the party day comes, it doesn't stay at 200. Usually I get outside orders, I get whatever, and it gets up over 5 or at least close. But on this side, she's not going to be able to just invest the 30 or 40 to get her bundle and make the meals with her friends. She's going to have 2 choices. Buy the bundle to help her party credit for full price, or wait and see how much credit she gets and make her meals alone afterwards. I hate recommending the latter to customers because I feel like it tells them basically, thanks for having the party. Good luck getting your meals done on your own. You know what I mean?
Right.
It's just one of those tough things. So positive, we need to encourage our new reps. I think Leah said she was on here. Lisa's on here. You guys, it's not Tabitha. We talked about parties today. It's not profitable for you to leave for a $200 party. There's the blunt answer. If you're getting a babysitter, you're not making money. And so the reality is, if we're going to stay in party planning until WildTree has better online systems and this app and function, I want you to make money. Whether you leave the house 1 time a month or 6 times a month, I want you to profit. Now, not saying don't do one-on-one consultations. I'm not saying don't do small parties. I have had great small parties. I think one of Tiff's was smaller than normal. Like, I think back, a while back, it was smaller. Like, she never made people register. She's a great rep on the team, rocking it. So, like, you don't prejudge, but you also have to stop thinking scarcity mindset. Like, I need to minimally get 200 or 350. And you need to think, like, what am I going to do to make every party on my calendar this month successful? Success. What does success look like? What's your definition? I don't look at the hostess that had a $200 party as a failure. But I also don't think of myself like, yay, kudos, that was a great party. Like, the reality is I need to keep working on my skills so that my hostesses are always having the best party possible. So I hope that's helpful. That's where my mindset shifted, is it's like, wow, if every rep came on board and thought $200 was okay and they do 4 parties a month at $200, your paycheck sucks. For the amount of time that you spend, I mean, it really does. I'm just going to say it. Like, why would you want to do this? Why would you want to leave the house 4 times and make that kind of money, when you could leave the house 4 times and make triple and probably be on your way to team leader and stuff? I know Jess will back me on this and Sarah will back me on this. The more sales you have, the more people you meet. Jess, we've talked about this many times. You don't grow a customer base if you leave the house every month for 3 people for each party. You want it to be 8. So it's going to help us with abundance, okay? That really is the major thing. $200 is nothing else in our business, and we're having a lot of reps do 1 or 2 parties, say it didn't make them any money and they can make more money with another company and leave. Especially when the company is from at home. And even if they don't make a lot of money with it, they weren't making a lot of money with WildTree. So what's the difference? We have to show them that our comp plan really is that great, but you got to have the sales to back it up. Is that helpful? I'm really passionate about this one because I don't want you guys to waste your time. So do what Tabitha did. Give me a sunburn, like talking to her on the phone today did, being outside. We had a great coaching call. It was constructive. I hope Tabitha agrees. It was helpful. And we really dug into the heart of where she needs to drive her energy. And I didn't even tell her it's parties. I actually told her something different. So each of you can tune into a training call if you'd like to know. Okay, there's that. So there's that change. What else am I missing? I know there's one more major one. Who knows it? I got to find it. Hold on. Let's see. You guys know Leslie stepped down. By the way, Leslie stepping down is not a reflection like we're going bankrupt or she's selling us off. She actually stepped down in January, and we were just asked not to make a big deal out of it so that reps were not personally reaching out to her to find out if she was okay or what was up. She's okay. She is dealing with some health issues, and it was just time. Does that make sense? Does anybody have questions about that? It's not a bad thing. Leslie just needs some time. She has worked this for 20 years full-time as a CEO, and she did parties in January and stuff, and I think she just burnt herself out. Any questions on that? Okay, so host program we covered. Easy Breezy Slow Cooker is coming back. Workshop kits are staying the same. We talked about the pricing structure, which you can find all of this in the email. Customer promotions, anybody hung up on that we're getting rid of the 50% off? You know, some are worried about their sales, and you can be honest on this call. Does anybody have specific questions or fears on that, on the 50% offs going away and the new menu planner coming out instead?
Can you explain the new menu planner part of it?
Yeah. So I'm excited. Those of you that know my business know that there's nothing that annoys me more than the gal who only wants to buy one jug of garlic grape seed oil a year when it's on sale because she doesn't want to pay $52 for it. She wants to pay a year $27.50 in my Wild Tree business. Cheese. Like, it's just not, I don't like it. That's the bottom line. It's annoying. So now I'm not saying that lots of customers didn't love the customer specials. You guys know this. I'm very good at upselling at my parties. So of course I sold a lot of 50% off specials, but I really think there's some perks to this. Number one, did you guys see how they advertised the free product, the recipes, all one shot? So not two specials a month to have. And the main feature, no $50 spend. If you don't want to buy a workshop bundle, buy the menu planner and just come and hang out at the tasting. You can coach your hostesses to say, we also have a fresh option. They wouldn't have to prep any groceries to come to the party, but they can still buy the bundle on the front end. Who thinks that's a pretty sweet deal? Because who thinks lugging your groceries, now that you actually know how to do a workshop, to a party sounds even a bit appealing? No, once you've done a workshop, it'd be more fun to pick up the bundle with the free product and show up and just pick it up at the party. Like, there's a lot of perks to it. Also, you guys know this, Jess, the brainchild of this, and Sam and myself and Carissa from another org, we're going to continue to do the weekly menu planners, and now we're going to start to make them so you guys can access them as a team. So what it'll do is you'll be selling off on week one or two of the month, the bundle for the month, and then we'll come out with a couple other weeks using those same products of recipes. What better service can you provide your customers? And we're going to do it for you, as long as you're nice. Otherwise, Jess and I were running to, what country do you want to go to, Jess? Now that I've seen Jamaica, I've seen Costa Rica, we're going to pick something different. Like, I've never seen Punta Cana. I'm up for that. So Dominican, right? So I'm up for that. And I love Mexico. You guys know that. I have no Espanol at all, but I just fit right in with tequila shots. So that's all I need. So I'm practicing getting my suntan on so I look good in Jamaica. Okay, so that's kind of my thought on that. Sarah, did that help you explain it? No 50% off bundles instead of free product and a menu planner service, but no $50 spend either.
So not it's still not overly clear. So you said something about a menu planner bundle and they get a free product in there. So what is all that's included?
It's on the flyer. Like, that is what it is now. Every month it's going to be five or six products bundled together, and it has a free Wild Tree sends. So it's
okay. So we're still gonna get the flyer that showcases.
Oh yeah,
a different bundle. This is just taking. It's just not half off. It's just straight up price.
Yeah. So it's five products. Okay. It's six products for the price of five, shipped to their doorstep. 8 or 10 recipes. I forget what it says. And then we as a team are gonna help you with the rest.
Gotcha. Okay.
Who else? That's a good question. Who else has a question on that? It's okay to be like grumpy too, or what? I'm only talking loud because I just don't know if you can hear me, but I feel like I'm probably screaming it. I should tone it down a bit. Can you still hear me okay?
Yeah.
If you can still hear me, then I was screaming. Okay. Here's why I drank wine on a Tuesday night. I'm getting in. No, I'm not. Nope, I'm not. Anybody else? Okay, so let's do this. Does anybody have a genuine, like, I'm most disappointed in this because I feel like it's going to affect my business like this?
I don't know. I guess my gut says that the price increases. I mean, when you think about going to parties and people complaining about the $78 for the bundle, you know, like, I don't think anybody's going to come because they don't want to pay that money. And then they have the price increase. But I mean, I agree 110% with the whole keep your energy high and don't dwell on that, but dwell more on the fact that this is a solution. This is helping your family, you know, and maybe we just have to start laying it out there for our customers that if you go to Subway, you know, you're dropping $30 on a family of four or whatever. If you go to McDonald's or Culver's or whatever, or if you're running to the grocery store for a couple of things, but you're doing that multiple times a week, there's the money that you'd be putting forth.
Oh my God.
You know, so maybe that's just how we have to start approaching it with our customers is be like, how would you spend this $78 otherwise or this $100 or whatever, you know?
I went into a lengthy discussion. So Tabitha, this is repeat. Sarah, this is repeat. But I think if you guys tuned in the other night, but oh my gosh, do people spend money when they want something? Period. I think food is intimidating because people don't want to do the work. So just check your energy. And the last thing I have to say on that is make sure, oh, I can't say this enough. Make sure you don't go into your parties after the price increase with catalogs that are outdated if you don't want to talk about the price increase. Because you're just asking yourself to have to, every time they come to checkout with something that's on the list, you're going to have to mention it, you know? Oh, hi, you're still awake. You're not sleeping yet. I've got 7 minutes. Okay, come back up. He's not sleeping. Surprise. Anybody want a baby? He's awfully cute. Well, Kali, can you giggle for them? Oh, we're freezing. Can you giggle quick for them? I think they want to giggle. I think they want to giggle. I bet you my phone's going to die. So I would just say to Sarah, yes, don't even talk about the price increase. Here's advice from your leader. You don't say anything about it unless somebody specifically asks you. That's it. You're not lying, but you're just going to have the right catalogs and you're not going to be like, hey, I'm Wildtree. And by the way, we had a major price increase last month. My leader said that I should cover this right away just to get it out of the way. Like, yeah, don't do that. I literally would just get the updated catalogs and you're not going to change a thing. And if people ask, you're going to say, yep, this year is the first year in forever that we had to do a full review of our product line. And a couple of products went up quite a bit. We were just way under cost. And unfortunately, like, we don't want to be a Leah Sophia. We don't want to be a company that closes the doors and sells their products online because it's cheaper. And that's a true thing. I feel bad for those folks that put their whole heart and soul into that company. And now they sell it as an online outlet, you guys. Wildtree could do that. But Southwestern Company at any point, like, anybody could. I mean, any company could do that. So I think, Sarah, if you're very honest, if someone brings it up, you can totally cover it with high energy. And like you said, people spend money. So just remind them without being offensive what they spend money on. I just saw a quote, an extra $1 million Starbucks made on the stupid unicorn thing, which was, I mean, it was beautiful. And even though I shared the nutrition facts, I wanted to go try it. Like, I'm not going to lie. Like, I wanted to try it too. But then I refused to give them my money after I saw everybody posting about it. So it had nothing to do with the ingredients. It had everything to do with, I didn't want to give them my money. So anyway, who else? That was great, Sarah. That was really good. I agree with you. My gut says it's going to be hard to sell pancakes and the breakfast items. My colleague just keeps coming in and tapping my leg like, good job, mama. You're doing a good job. Unreal.
I have a question.
Yeah.
If somebody likes one of your products and you know it's going to go up in June, would it be okay to contact them and let them know in case they wanted to get stock up?
Sure.
Before the price increase?
I just, guys, one thing I love that I can say on this call, and this is recorded now so our whole team can watch it, don't comment that kind of stuff on a thread. Right? We all know, like, why put it out there for the public? But if you want to private message them and say, hey, you bought 6 chicken bouillons last month. Like, I just have this, like, cool idea. I don't know if chicken bouillon's going up. I'm just making this up. But it's going to go up. And so at the end of May, do you want me to contact you and we'll put in a nice size order? And absolutely. I would definitely.
Okay.
Yeah. And you could even run some specials, you guys, at Christmas time. I don't know if you saw, I never do 40% off because I just think that's not fair to everybody else that I can do that. So I rarely do it. But at Christmas time, I ran 40% off all the discontinued items. And I pulled in like $2,000 of excess sales at the end of the year. So people, if you're giving them a heads up. Now, I didn't know there was going to be an outlet with the items available. So I basically killed my customers using the, I mean, some of them have bought the blueberry and jam and stuff, but I mean, duh, at the end of the day, but it was fun. It was a fun way for December to raise my paycheck up a bit because I didn't have a ton going on. I had two cancellations right there and I only booked like four parties in the front half of December. And so it wasn't super ideal, if that makes sense. So I did something crazy. So Lisa, I'm not saying do that, but I'm just saying like, you could definitely tell them. Yeah, I think that's smart. Anybody else? That's great. These are great. Because people are going to watch this, you guys. Some people are just in bed or they couldn't tune in tonight. Tiff's not in bed. No, I can't imagine that's her bed. But some people are going to watch this back. And so some of them, to be honest, some people aren't on this call because they are going for team leader and some really crazy goals this month. So they're out doing, just like me, multiple parties this month, which is awesome. So if you watch this back later, ladies, cheers to you. Not that Sarah's not. Sarah's on the call tonight. And she, are you over leader numbers yet, Sarah? I haven't looked.
Yes.
Yay! Woo woo!
Yay!
Voted! Yay! With days to spare.
Yep.
Okay, so who else has something? We've got 3 minutes, otherwise I'll cut it off early. I really do look sunburned. My face is hot.
I just want to tell you that I am in my bed right now.
Yay, I knew it. Is that LuLaRoe?
No.
Oh. Oh, looks cute. It looks comfy. Anybody? Anybody? 2.5 minutes. Who else has a question? Here, I guess I'll give you some advice and you can quickly interrupt me. My advice is just get excited about the app. Focus on abundance, how you're going to work your business smarter, not harder, and really work with your hostesses. Be honest and upfront if someone confronts you about a change, but don't you dare let it change how you do your business. Like, keep rocking and only use it to fuel you, because I can promise you when we come home from conference, that Zoom call that I have scheduled that like first Monday right after to get everybody up to date, if you can't come, it's going to be awesome. There's only awesomeness that comes from changes like this, and they're doing it to protect the business, okay? Sanara is going to lose major people in her org over this. You guys, people will leave over something like this. Literally. People will leave. Tabitha's shaking her head. Yes, she knows. Jess, you know. We had it after Thatcher came live. Jess had been in business only 6 months, 5 months, and Jess Schultz had been in business 3 days. And Thatcher was a nightmare. We can tell you really fun stories if you come to our next team social at Applebee's, where we will drink sangrias all night long and rehash the fun Thatcher days. But if you made it through Thatcher, you were called one of the strong, because we lost a third of the company nearly during Thatcher. It was bad. It was really bad. They were trying. It wasn't lack of effort by the home office. I'll just give you an example. I placed an order on January 3rd and got 5 times the order. It was like $1,000 order. 5 times the order showed up. 27 boxes. Oh, mm-hmm. Was not good.
First of all, when is conference again? June?
July.
July.
No, 14th through 16th. If you're just coming for leader training in the morning on Friday, Saturday and Sunday, Friday afternoon, Saturday and Sunday morning are all for everybody. Friday mornings are. You should all be coming if you can. Even if you're a part-time rep, if you can get there that weekend, it's amazing.
And then when the social that you were talking about, is there a date for that?
No, we need to set one. And everybody's so darn busy and I have Jamaica. But maybe from Jamaica, I'll have time to lay on the beach with my calendar and I'll message you all some dates, okay?
All right.
I'm not kidding either. You guys know I'm not actually going to not work the whole time. I mean, I love to work, so I'll work. But I do have everything cinched ahead, so don't think I'm like a workaholic. Every group, everything is all set. So I am going to take some time off and try not to get from. The leader got it under control. I have no worries at all. Okay. Thank you guys for tuning in. Comment below this after I...